Osgood Schlatter's. They call it a disease, but it's not actually
a disease.
Yeah, I don't know why they call it a disease. So it's Osgood Schlatter's of the knee. And what happens is it's most.
What is it?
It's basically a pulling away of the patella tendon. So on the knee, where the. From below the kneecap, where that comes down, inserts onto the top of the tibia.
You know what I'm gonna do as soon as we're in the class.
Okay. So it inserts onto the top of the knee, and what happens is it starts to pull and gets really, really tight, and starts to pull away at the bone. And from there, then you start to get a little bit of tenderness and inflammation occurring on the attachment site. There we go. So, oops. So the patella tendon, so our kneecap. Comes down into our patella tendon, and that attaches onto this piece of bone here. And what happens is, as we grow, and the bones start to lengthen, the bones tend to grow a little bit quicker than our muscles do. So what happens is, during these growth periods, we're in kind of a red zone, if you will, where the bones are lengthening, muscles are staying relatively still, and the muscles then get really, really tight because they're not stretching or growing with the at the same rate of the bone. And what happens then is this bone then starts to become really, really inflamed and really, really irritable and really, really sore to put pressure on. Now it soars after activity, or can be brought on by activity. And the reason for that is because what do we do in our activity? We're using the muscles. So those muscles are contracting and relaxing, contracting, relaxing. So they're getting tighter and tighter when we run, kick a ball, or do anything like that. And as a result then, if you're suffering from this, it gets sore and sore as it progresses. Generally, we would see the young kids complain of getting pain when they're playing or directly after they're playing. But generally, it settles down a day or two after a rest, but as soon as they go back playing sport again, it all comes back again. So it's kind of a
and often they think they're okay, and then they'll go and play a game, and then I've had parents ring me the next day where they can't even send them to school because they're crying that much about the pains in their knees.
It is quite sore, and if you keep going, what you can actually develop is you can develop a nice big lump forming on the front of the shin here as well. So the bone actually grows outwards, and you can develop kind of like a golf ball.
The muscle literally pulls it off.
So it just keeps pulling, and because they're growing, the bone starts to grow in the direction of the force. So it's been pulled out that way. So the bone just keeps loading and growing out there. And that can become really, really awkward then to actually kneel down on. So that's what the condition is.
Is it serious?
No. Really, really common. A little bit more common, I would say, in boys than girls. I think that's just to do with the amount of activity boys tend to get involved.
I had a girl last week actually, and
yeah, I have seen girls.
Yeah, and she's a really active little girl. Like, not only is she doing lots of sport, but she's on the trampoline continuously at home. So I think the key is activity.
So what do we try and do in physio? Well, first thing, if your child has this, I would probably recommend just rest for a couple of weeks to see if that alone will help settle down. Give them a chance to let their muscles start to stretch.
What do you mean rest though?
So if someone is complaining of that, I would just say stop playing sports for 2 weeks, complete rest. No kicking ball in the yard, no running around, just give yourself a chance. If that doesn't solve it, then what I would do is I would probably get it seen to, because there's some stretches that you can be doing. So the stretches on the quad you can do. Sometimes the hamstrings can also help to stretch them out, and doing a little bit of calf stretching as well can also help. From there then as well, we look to try and strengthen the muscles. So what we know is that when kids go, when anyone goes and plays sport, we start to lower the muscles. And when we lower those muscles, the muscles get nice and tight as we're playing. Now the weaker the muscle, the quicker that tightness comes on. So we know that if we get this muscle nice and strong, and the muscles around the area nice and strong, they can do more before they start to get that same tightness. And that can also help reduce those symptoms, or allow them to do a lot more before that same pain comes on. Often, as I said, it's only a phase for some kids, that it's just a matter of a few weeks or a few months for them to get through that phase, let their muscles catch up to the bones, and then they're fine after that. but it is something that, if not managed, it can get really, really sore and really frustrating. I'm trying to tell a kid then to stop playing for a few weeks is like asking him to stop playing for a year in a kid's life. So
it is. And I think the big one for us on this is to really get the parents to understand what's going on and to get them on board so that they can adhere to the kind of plan that we put in place. Ollie is spot on. Like, the strength work is key, because I've had cases come in that have rested, that have done stretches, and then as soon as they go back to sport, they're getting the pain again. And the element that was missing was the strength work. You have got to get that quad stronger to tolerate the load.
Yeah.
And then, like, we would normally start with non-load-bearing strength work for this, or I would anyway, I don't know about you.
You said non-load-bearing.
So what I would notice is the kids can't tolerate getting up from a chair, like the squatting position, mm-hmm. or stepping up on a step or stepping down.
Put more stress and strength.
Exactly, so it's too sore.
So you'd be doing some.
So I start a straight leg raise, something where their foot is not on the floor and they're not tolerating. Then they can tolerate the load, or you might even have to strip it back to like inner range quad exercises, so really basic exercises. Then they do that for a week, and then Deborah's distracting us. I have a Christmas mug. Deborah's just said, I'm glad to see Ollie got a nicer mug. It even has his name on it, Deborah, show her name on the back.
It was a nice present. Present see? Made from one of my friends.
On the back. There we go. This was a present too, actually, from a patient last Christmas. All right. And I haven't broke it.
Right.
Still going strong. I totally got distracted. So yeah, we would start with non-weight-bearing strength work. And then progressive, starting with things like step-ups and then squatting. It's really important as well if the parent can understand that they have to be able to jump pain free before they can play, then you can make it very clear that, look, we're going to do this, and then as soon as we can do this, we're going to be able to go back to training.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing about these kids, Ollie, that comes up a lot is that you might get them back and they're doing really well, but then we have this issue, particularly with these kids, the boys, when they're maybe 14, 15, and they're playing multiple sports, and once you've told them they can go back training, they think that's it, right?
Yeah.
I can play my soccer, I can play my school football, I can play everything.
Yeah.
And 3 weeks later, lo and behold, phone rings again. And really, we've managed that poorly. With these kids, there has to be a graded return to the sports.
Yeah, gradual load, gradual increase. So even starting back, start at their own age group. If they're under 10, keep them at under 10, rather than playing under 12 and under 13, playing on 4 or 5 different age groups, and then going on to playing different sports then as well. And then that aside, then they're playing in the school as well. So it's a lot of activity. Now, we do want our kids to be active, and we're not saying that we don't want them to be active, but when they start to get pain and start to suffer, they're doing too much. So we need to reduce it down, and you need I would say sit the child down and agree with them which one
exactly.
You want to do. You can do one of them for the next few weeks. It'll only be 2 to 3 sessions a week. You're giving yourself a time to rest in between then. So, and you're giving them the choice then, the freedom to make the decision.
The other thing as well, and I think as a parent, it's only natural, they'll worry about the bony change that's happening at the front,
mm-hmm.
because when these kids come in, literally they will not let you touch that section of the knee joint. They will not want to kneel on it. And the parents are worried because they can see the deformity that's happened at the front of the knee. Now, the swelling, the puffiness around it and the redness will go, but often if somebody's had a moderate to severe case of Oscar-Schlatter's, that bump will be there because it's a bony growth. And it will stay there forever, and it will not do anyone any harm, ever. So if you have a grown male in the house, go and have a feel of the front of his knee, because there's a chance that he does have the remnants of what would have been Oscar Schlatter's back in the day. So that bone won't change. We don't need to do anything with it. The sensitivity will go down over time. And that's the other thing that I do with these kids. Once this pain starts to settle, I practice getting them kneeling on the knee again, because they can become quite fearful of that pressure on the front of the knee.
Mm-hmm. But that's once the pain is settled.
Yeah, they're squatting and doing their step-ups comfortably, then absolutely putting the pressure onto it. So I would normally start that on the bed with pillows and get them to even have all the weight on, if it's only one side that's symptomatic, have all the weight on the other leg, or start in 4-point kneeling and take the weight on gradually. and then you maybe use a towel on the bed instead of a pillow, then take away the towel, and then put the pillow back on the floor, towel on the floor, and then onto the floor. So you make sure that that knee sensitivity is addressed as well.
Confession to make, I actually had this when I was
Tell them how yours was managed, Ollie. You didn't do what you were told.
Mine was managed. I was a brat. I played on loads of different teams and loads of different sports. Well, soccer, hurling, and Gaelic. And I refused to listen and take the advice, despite physio sessions, despite
consultants, mom, dad, parents, and physios telling them to stop.
So I ended up actually in a full cast from hip all the way down to my ankle for 6 weeks to stop me from playing and to give my leg a rest. The pain settled down, but I was at a much greater disadvantage because all my muscles on my left side had become nice and weak as a result.
They disappeared to nothing in that cast.
So yeah, I should have just done what I was told, but anyway, lesson learned. Now
still
I'm trying to preach.
But actually, he threatens his kids with that.
Yeah.
And so they don't belong then doing their exercises, because the beauty of it is you can do your strength work, you can keep your strength up.
Yeah.
You just can't load it through running, hopping, jumping.
So is there anywhere else we might see this happen in the body? There's two areas. So this at the knee, and we also see it somewhere else.
It can also happen, again, if they're young and they're doing lots of jumping, hopping, running with sport, if you load your calf. And instead of the patella tendon pulling, it's the Achilles tendon on the back of the heel. Yeah, I hope that's right answer.
Yeah, that's right answer, yeah. So it's called Sever's, again, they call it Sever's disease. It's not a disease. It's a Sever's
disease.
For a Sever's syndrome. Yeah. And again, you get the exact same, the Achilles tendon pulls at the back of that heel bone, and the heels can become really, really sore and really, really tender as well. And it's the exact same management as the knee. Rest for a few weeks, see if that settles it. If it's not, then you need to start to engage in some stretching, some strengthening while resting, and then gradually build up the load.
Load it back up, yeah.
Load it back up again. But yeah, they're probably the two biggest ones we would see with kids.
I have to say, like, if we have problems in rehabbing these, it's simply because the kids jump back in when they shouldn't have. Or they come in limping and they admit there was a game on Tuesday and they just had to play. Because when you stop them, the pain will go. It will abolish and they'll feel really good and they'll think they can play, but they can't. It has to be a graded return. Alright, so if they come in and haven't played, then we threaten them with the cast. So that's Osgood Slatter. So any of you mums out there that have growing boys that are complaining about sore knees or sore heels, it's very likely that the mismatch is between the length of the bone and the muscle growing. It will settle with time.
The muscle will catch up
with
the bone.
It just takes time.
A bit longer process for the muscle to lengthen.
And if it isn't settling, you know, within a week or two with just rest, then get into your chartered physio for advice, because it lingers on and on. And they tend up on in and out of sport, and you can actually end up with a very, very sore front of that knee if it's mismanaged. So get in for advice and exercises. But it's absolutely nothing serious, so don't worry.
No.
Hopefully that covers that. Thanks for watching.
Enjoy.
Bye.